Hi, do you like the background of this video? What about this one? Maybe you like this one for sure. Wait, we have one more for you. Want to add these kind of backgrounds to your videos? Then here are the 4 different ways to create animated backgrounds using one simple tool called Animaker. Are you excited? Let's begin. Visit this website called Animaker.com. Animaker is an online DIY tool that lets you create animated and live action videos for free. Once you sign up, you'll be redirected to the dashboard page. From here, create a new project based on the video type that you want to create. You can create vertical, horizontal, and square videos. For this tutorial, I'm using a horizontal video. Let's start with adding some colors to the background. Click anywhere on the background. Just right above it, you can see the option to change its color. We can also create gradient backgrounds by adding multiple colors using the option over here. As the next step, let's add a shape to the background. Open the section named as Property from the library. This section has more than 70,000 icons and properties that you can use in your videos. I'm using a gradient shape. You can use any of these shapes and create an unique background. Similar to how we changed the color of the background, we can change the color of the gradient too. Now to make the property move, select the option Smart Move present next to the Change Color option. You can see a lot of preset animations over here. We can also add custom animations to the shape. Let's select the Rotate Animation option. Now on the timeline we can see 2 thumbs. They represent the start and end duration of the rotate animation that we applied. I want the shape to rotate throughout the scene's duration, so let's move the second thumb to the end of the scene. I want to add a few more of these shapes. Let's copy and paste it by pressing Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V on your keyboard. Press Command-C and Command-V if you are using a Mac. Just to add a little more variation to the shape, let me increase its size and rotate it. Let's repeat the same steps and add one more shape. We can preview the animation using the option right above the timeline. You can download this background as a video or as a GIF using the Publish option present at the top menu. Let's start with adding some color to the background. Click on the Change Color option and change the background color. As the next step, get to the bottom left hand side and click on the option named as More. Now again select the option Jiffy Stickers. I want to add some flowers to the background, so let's search for it. You can simply copy and paste a GIF multiple times by pressing Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V. To duplicate multiple GIFs together, click on your mouse and drag the pointer over them. Now press the same Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V keys to duplicate them. As simple as that. You can use Command-C and Command-V keys if you are using Mac. I'm adding few more Jiffy stickers from the library. Now I'm going to select this dove. Right now the dove is moving in the same place. We are going to make it fly between different places. Select this option named as Smart Move. You can see that the sticker is moving between 2 different points. Let's make it enter through the left side and exit on the right side. On the timeline, we can see 2 thumbs. They represent the duration taken by the GIF to move between these 2 points. Let's give the dove 5 seconds to fly across the scene. You can preview the animation applied using the play option right above the timeline. You can download this background as a video or as a GIF using the Publish option over here. Open the video section of the library and search for the word pattern. You can preview any of the videos over here by just keeping the pointer over it. Once you click on a video, it will apply as the background. You can download it as a GIF or as a video using the publish option at the top menu. As simple as that. For the first background, we used a property from the library, and for the second background, we used the Jiffy stickers. For this one, we'll be using both of them together. Let's start with applying some colors to the background. Click on the change color option at the top. I want the background to look like sky, so I'm adding shades of blue. As the next step, let's select some clouds from the property section. Let's change its color using the change color option. Let's apply animation effect to it using the smart move option. We have to make it enter through the bottom and exit at the top. This will give a falling effect to the cartoon character that we will be adding later. You can use the thumbs on the timeline to control how quickly the cloud should pass. Let's give around 1 second as the duration between these thumbs. Similarly, let's add few more different shaped clouds from the properties section and add smart move animation to them. As the next step, we are going to add the Jiffy sticker. For that, click on the More option from the library and click on the Jiffy sticker section. Now search for the word falling and select this falling cartoon character over here. Let's reduce the extra duration present on the scene. For that, we have to use these plus and minus options present at the bottom of the timeline. Let's preview the scene using the preview option right above the timeline. That's it, your animated background is ready. You can download it either as a video or as a GIF using the publish option over here. Now that you know how to create your own animated backgrounds, it's time for you to give it a try. If you found this video helpful, give it a like and do let us know your thoughts on the comments.